Hi, welcome to today's video. The Institute for Supply Management's Non-Manufacturing Purchasing Manager Index increased by 3 points to 59.7 in February, higher than the market had expected. Market Eurozone Services PMI got revised up by 0.5 points to 52.8 in February. Market United Kingdom Services PMI rose by 1.2 points to 51.3. Also, the PMI in Switzerland and Japan also rose. The same index for China, Kaixin China General Services PMI, fell by 2.5 points to 51.1. Bank for International Settlements quarterly review reports that the events at the end of 2018 in the financial markets highlight two features of the economic and financial landscape. One, in the background and little noticed except by practitioners, is the change in the day-to-day functioning of financial markets since the Great Financial Crisis. Financial regulations, unconventional monetary policies, and fragmented financial markets have made the theory of covered interest parity to be broken, as observed by much larger spikes in interest rates at quarter to year-end, and that uncollateralized rates for overnight transactions among the private sector are below the risk-free rates on central bank deposit. The author in the foreground and commanding widespread attention is the close interaction between central banks and markets. Financial markets scrutinize central banks everywhere to get a hint about which direction the monetary policy is heading. Central banks in turn scrutinize financial markets to better understand what the expectations of the economy are, as markets both reflect and influence activity. This interaction helps explain the Federal Reserve's recent patience in its monetary policy. BIS also reports that the intention behind European Central Bank asset purchasing program was to persuade investors to take more risk by investing in other kind of assets than the government bonds. This intention, however, didn't turn out as expected. The review finds that non-bank financial institutions located outside the euro area were active as sellers of government bonds, and the proceeds was deposited in the banks outside the eurozone, mostly in the United Kingdom. The Bank of England has thus warned that a Brexit with no deal will have large consequences due to financial regulations will be changed overnight, and the uncertainty will rise greatly. And that's it for today's video. Check the video description for more details. Thank you for watching.